Tiger, Financial News Network. TFNN, Headline News Update.
Rhodes coming to you live from the shores of sunny but cool and brisk Delray Beach, Florida. This is your 9 a.m. update. Currently, we have all the U.S. index futures trading lower. The Dow is off 287 points. It's 0.8%. 0.9% for the NASDAQ. That's down 139. The S&P, about 0.8, 0.9, 39 points. The Russell is off a little over 1%. That's 23 points to the downside. Gold's up $4. Silver's down 12 pennies. Light sweet crude is up 12 cents. The 30-year Treasury is flat, trading out at 156.16. So what do all these numbers mean out here? Well, let's go take a look at our nine-panel market update chart. We begin by taking a look at the ES Mini. What we know is the ES Mini is trading below the bottom of its daily profile. And that could target, that could send a target, a signal to you and I that price is making its way back to the bottom of its weekly profile. And that's at 45.49. If we take a look at the spot volatility, it's well above its 50-day exponential moving average. That is at 1954. It's trading at 2187. The signal here is that maybe it's going to go target 2375. That's the top of its 50-to-1 Bollinger band. Regardless, if the 50-day if the spot volatility remains above its 50-day, that always puts pressure on the ES Mini and the S&P 500. The NASDAQ is trading below the bottom of its daily profile, but right back at a support level, which is the top of its weekly profile. That's at 15.303. The real support here is 15.104. If the NQ were to close below 15.104 today, well, one, that would suggest a move down to 14.804. And if 14.804 gets taken out, then we have a change in trend signal for the NQ. The U.S. dollar index, it's got an A to B equals CD pattern. If it forms a bullish reversal candle today, that will generate a Gartley buy. If it doesn't, then price should head lower. There's a breakout level at the 93 and change area out there, so that would become its target. You've got Goldilocks testing a key level of resistance, the top of its weekly profile, 1828.50. A close above that this week, that would be a bullish outcome. The silver contract actually just generated a new profile. It wasn't there this morning. Price is testing that resistance level. That's now at 2334, so it's met that. If price can close above that, 2334, that is, that would be a bullish outcome for silver. Light sweet crude, yesterday. Today generated a sell the D point. Today is going to be a TD 9 count top. Looks like late spring, but it just formed a new profile as well, which is below price. That's a bullish message out here. Wow. Hey, folks, stay tuned. Tommy O'Brien is up next, and have a fantastic Friday. And do me a favor on Monday, tune in to the Trader's Edge show. That starts at 1 o'clock sharp. Take care, folks. Have a great day.